Hi, my name is David and welcome back to another video with our Ghost Pro printer. You have seen the video maybe where we're unboxing and first installing that printer, and then maybe another video where we're doing the first printouts. Today we're going to take an in-depth look on some of the features of Ghost Pro and especially on how to create your designs, how to create your files to really get what you want from it. But before I jump into the video, I'd like you to ask us to subscribe to the channel. Make sure that you hit the bell button so that you get notified on any new updated videos. In today's video, we're going to make a design for a save the date wedding invitation card. Ghost Pro is perfect for printing on any type of heavier media. So whether this is like cards, invitations, or even like big A3 or SAR3 posters, this is what Ghost Pro really is made for. It's also made for volume printing. So that's a heavy duty printer, as you can see from its size and overall appearance. So for this printer, printing hundreds of wedding invitations or posters or cards or envelopes is the perfect job. That's the perfect tool for the job. I'm going to take you to my computer screen and you will be able to see on the screen how I do align my design. For today's example, we are going to print on a green card. And the thing with Ghost Pro is that compared to our other white toner printers, the printer does know that it has a white toner cartridge. The white toner is a permanent part of the Ghost Pro setup. You can see that Ghost Pro comes with its white, cyan, magenta, and yellow toner, so there is no black toner in Ghost Pro. Ghost Pro is mixing black as a color from cyan, magenta, and yellow. So Ghost Pro does know that it has a white cartridge. Thus, you can make your design on the screen without having to swap black and white like you would with Little Ghost or other white toner printers. That's a big difference for you to keep in mind if you're used to our regular white toner printers where you swap the black and the white cartridge. Everything in black on the screen prints in white. It's different here. Everything white on the screen also prints in white. So you can actually make your design the way you want it to look as the final result. In my case, my green card will actually have a green background on the screen and the printed colors in white on the screen already, so that I can see quite a good preview of what I'm going to do on the screen before I even print it out. But there's one thing to keep in mind. To make it as easy as possible for you as the user, we have defined certain paper colors and attached some CMYK values to these paper colors so that you can make that design and have an automatic setting in the printer driver. For example, for this actual card, what I'm going to do is I'm going to define in the printer driver that my paper color is green and I have a green backing in specific cyan, magenta, yellow, and black values in my design program in InDesign. And then I'm just going to tell the printer before printing, automatic background for green paper. So the printer knows I've got green paper, and then it's going to print on the green paper without printing a green background, but removing the background. So basically, we don't have to trick the printer. The printer knows what to do. We just have to bear a few steps in mind. I'll show you another example quickly. In our next video, we're going to print this poster for a burger shop. And as you can see, it's printed on a black cardboard, on a very heavy duty black cardboard. And I wanted my whole background to be black, except for the burger itself, my designing, and my telephone number and my order now button. So I told the printer that I have a black paper. My design on the screen was black, as my design here will be green. And then I said automatic background for black paper, and it removes all the black and doesn't actually print a black in the background. But you will see that in a minute. So let's head over to the computer screen and check our save the date card. I'm in InDesign and I've got my page here. And my design today consists of different elements. I'm quickly going to walk you through the elements and highlight the importance of each element. So I've got my text elements here, Lily and Gabe. I could save the date, we say yes, we keep you updated. So these are my text elements, and as you can see, I've already set my text to white by just, you know, marking the text and going to my color and say it's like the paper color, it's like a pure white. I could also set it to white, but this will be good. Then I've got a PNG on this side. So this is a stock image PNG, which I downloaded. So it's a transparent vector image of these wedding rings, pretty nice. I can align this a little bit like that. And then my most important element actually is the background. I can move that around for you a little bit so you can see that. So that's the background. I made the background a little bit bigger than my actual workspace is here. You could also use Photoshop or any other graphic software, but please bear in mind you need to work in CMYK here. This is a CMYK printer, so that makes it really important. If I open the color tab, you can see the CMYK values that I have set for this background. 85, 50, 70, and 50. These are the specific CMYK values, and please ignore the other HSB, RGB, lab, and also the hashtag for the hex code. Please ignore these. Please work in CMYK, because this value is specified for the printer to represent a green paper. So the printer will delete the background automatically on the print job. It's really cool that the printer comes with a little cheat sheet that gives you all the different values for CMYK designing for the different predefined paper types. So, for example, for black paper, you've got 00100, of course. For white, you got just zeroed out. Blue, yellow, and here's the green. So 85, 50, 70, 50 are the CMYK values. So these are no toner values, that's what we call them. So no toner values, values where no toner is going to be laid down in print. This cheat sheet comes with your printer, but you can also just download it from our website and use it for you. So back on the screen, I just save my color settings here quickly. And now I'm just going to open the print dialog and just go to print. In this print dialog, I have already set the correct media. I've set it that the printer driver is going to define the media, and I've just printing all pages. Now I'm going to the settings of the printer. I've chosen my Ghost Pro printer, and I'm going to settings. And now this is where the fun part begins. So first I'm going to make my settings in here. So I'm going to choose my material. First I'm going to choose the format, and I'm going to choose A5 because that's what I'm printing on. Then I'm going to choose the color of my media, and that'll be green, that's correct. And I'm going to choose the type of my paper, and this is just a carton. So now that we've set the paper size, the paper color, and the paper type to cardboard, we're going to go to the toner settings, that's here, and we're telling the printer, so you can see that we had only use white toner, gray paper or transparent, black, white paper, blue, yellow, green paper, that's what we want. So we tell them automatic settings for green paper, so it's going to have the background removed automatically because we chose the correct values in our background here. And then we just say print. The driver is going to send it over to the printer. Once I've sent the print job over to the printer will ask me on the screen to insert the right media. So I can just insert the media. And on the screen, I just can confirm what I've inserted. A5, cardboard green, and I just say okay. And now it will just start get the media in. Once the print job is done, we can take it out and we can see that we get the design printed exactly as we planned to. Green card, no background printed, and just the beautiful white print. The printer is capable of handling heavy paper, even with this kind of like a textured paper. So really nice. And of course, it's also able to handle multiple jobs at a time, one job after the other. So the really cool thing about Ghost Pro is not only that you can print production size jobs in a very decent speed and with a printer that is able to handle very, very high grammages, you can also have a screen preview, a real screen preview with no design limits really of what you want to do. So you have a green card on the screen as seen in the screencast before, and you get your green card printed. So no more thinking around the edge when making your designs. So this is really great. And of course, one more thing you will see in the next video is that it's able to print white as a base layer and color over it in one pass. That is one more advantage of Ghost Pro, because this way you can do multicolor printing on dark media without any two-time printing or any double pass printing. If you like the video, please leave us a thumbs up below. As I said before, follow the channel and check the description for all the media that we used and for the printer and for links to our webshop. I say thanks for watching and see you next time.